Hello from the KCOM Stadium here in Hull. I'm Derek Ray, joined by Lee Dixon in the commentary position. And looking forward to bringing you the cut and thrust of the Championship. It's Hull City, and they take on Sheffield United.
Thanks, Derek. Well, both managers will be reminding their players how important it is to get off to a quick start here, attack the game from the off, impose your game plan, and hopefully we get a good game.
Here's how the lineup looks for Hull City. How the lineup looks for Sheffield United. Well, they are a team very much designed to hit on the break. Lee, is that something we can expect to see today?
Yeah, I think so, Derek. They do tend to prefer to invite their opponents onto them and utilise their pace to exploit the space on the counter to good effect.
Thank you. Enjoy the game.
And the game begins. Well, not quite what he wanted to do with the pass. Lundstrom. And it's with Robinson. Well, they couldn't keep possession. Matty Longstaff. No, high quality defending. I believe there's been a goal in the Norwich game. Alan?
It's a goal for Norwich City. 5 minutes played, 1-0.
Thanks very much as always, Alan. Couldn't keep it. Excellent vision. Silva. How can they create something? Oh, so near, off the post. Well, he's given a corner, the referee. And now the delivery. I don't think in the grand scheme of things he's going to be terribly proud of that headed attempt.
Well, heading practice in training next week, that was pretty average, to be fair.
Berge. And it's with Khazri. Silva. Well, great read there to intercept. And a goal has gone in at Selhurst Park. Let's hear about it from Alan.
It's a goal for Swansea City. 21 minutes played, 1-1.
Alan McAnally keeping us right up to date. Harrop. Longstaff. And the referee sees that as a foul. Free kick given. A fine reading of the situation. And can they exploit the space out wide? And a fine cross. Struggling to get it away. Takes it on. And it's in! 1-0. They've breached the defence.
Well, all the players have bought into the coach's vision of how to win the ball back high up the pitch. Pressing football like this is a joy to watch for me, Derek.
So the match has restarted. 1-0 here. Top class defending. Wabi Kazri. And a chance to whip it in here. March. And let's join Alan McInally now, because I'm hearing there's been a goal on the Sheffield Wednesday match. Alan.
It's a goal for Stoke City. 35 minutes played. 1-0.
Cheers again, Alan. And will it be the leveller? It has to be. A goal! Real excitement. A back and forth type of game. Now they're level.
Well, here's the replay. Great disguise on the pullback cross, and he had choices of what type of finish to apply. And bang, he goes for the smash. Lovely goal.
Well, the earlier goal cancelled out. One apiece. And very deftly cut out. And a throw-in forthcoming. Matty Longstaff. It might be on for them. Can he put them in front? Yes is the emphatic answer. And you have to say, it was on the cards. Well, as they kick off again, 2-1 the current state of affairs. Well, just 1 minute of time added on for stoppages here. Emmanuel Boateng. Well, he's won the ball. And so it is, the first half story has been written. I think most fans would be pretty happy with this man's display so far.
Wow, he's simply the difference between these two sides. All the eyes will be on him for this second half. Can he get that?
As anticipated, plenty of talking points so far. And now the second half is underway. Really good high press. That is how to apply the pressure. A goal has been scored in the Crystal Palace match. Alan McInally with details.
It's a second goal for Crystal Palace. It's been scored by Raul Rudiaz. A horrible slice clearance fell kindly to him, and he fired home. 49 minutes played. 2-1.
Thank you, Alan McInally. Well, racing past his... And in with a real chance. In it goes! That will greatly help their cause. Now they only need to keep concentration levels high.
Well, here it is again. He does so well to slip past his man, left him stranded. And how strong was he here? Incredible to hold off the defenders and get his shot away. Lovely goal.
So there it is, 3-1 the current scoreline here. And that is going to be a free kick. Well, let's bring in Alan McInally to tell us about a goal that's been scored at Carrow Road. Alan.
It's a goal for Derby County. 56 minutes played. 1-1.
Regular updates from Alan McInally along the way. That's a very impressive piece of defending. Being pressed and pressed high. Well, a fascinating piece of transfer business has gone through. I can tell you that Memphis Depay has completed his move to Inter.
A reported fee of around £80 million. Huge amount of money. Responsibility on a player's shoulders with that sort of price tag is huge. But he's a huge player. Big personality.
Breaking at pace. Oh, great vision. Oh, he's through here. And he clears it out of harm's way. Fabio Silva. Cuts it back. Longstaff. And let's join Alan Mac. Can Ali now, because I'm hearing there's been a goal on the Sheffield Wednesday match. Alan. He's in with a chance. Can he convert? And the challenge, crisp and clean. Carabao Cup excitement to look forward to, live here on EA TV. It's Sheffield United taking on Blackburn Rovers.
Knockout football, Derek, you know it's my favourite. Properly focuses the mind, that does. Well, it should do anyway. I'm looking forward to it.
Straight into the meat of the penalty area.
The hosts have really controlled possession. If you have that much of the ball, you can put pressure on the opposition defence. And they look like they're creaking. That's why they're winning comfortably.
It might be on for them. Oh, tremendous block. Could be. And that's the hat-trick. Tearing apart this defence time and again. They simply can't handle him.
Well, having scored two, he's going to get the hat-trick at some point, you feel. He's just so full of confidence. Never looked like missing.
It's a massive lead, and it's very hard to imagine them losing it now. Well, we had to interrupt Alan McInally just then. Apologies for that. To confirm, Sheffield Wednesday have scored in that match, and the match is level at 1-1. Lost possession. And news coming through that a goal has been scored at Villa Park. Details from Alan McInally.
It's a second goal for Aston Villa. 10 minutes remain. 2-1.
Thanks very much, as always, Alan. Fruitful looking attack. After the foul, a chance to contemplate what is next, and perhaps a goal from this free kick. And touched onto the frame of the goal. So the corner played into the box. Taking care of business defensively here. Played into the centre. Not to be this time. Berge. And Ben Osborne has it. Not advantage with them. Referee says play on. Oh, what an opportunity. A 1v1 situation, and the goalkeeper does his job.
Really good experience there. Picked his time. Really good save.
Played into the centre of the box. And it all counts for naught. We have entered the final minute of normal time. John Fleck. Baldock. Useful looking position, you've got to say. And there it is, the final whistle, and the fans will be leaving the stadium. Oh, so near!
Got time for just a few questions? That'll be all.